Hi, everyone. I'm Conrad Fischer. I'm the Residency Program Director in Brookdale Hospital in New York City, and welcoming you to try and take an experiment with Master the Wards. How do you get it right the first time, make a first impression that goes well, and also make sure that you know how to take care of patients for the most common chief complaint to be admitted to the hospital, shortness of breath. Now, how fast did this happen? Because acute onset of shortness of breath is a very limited number of things. Acute onset of shortness of breath is things like asthma, pulmonary embolus, CHF, asthma, pulmonary embolus, CHF, asthma, pulmonary embolus, CHF, and pneumothorax. Asthma, pulmonary embolus, CHF, pneumothorax. Do you have chest pain with that? And does it change with position, pleuritic, or chest wall tenderness? And here's the other thing is it getting better or worse with walking? Acute onset of shortness of breath, worse with exertion, is a disaster. Hurry, hurry, hurry. And this is the other thing also. Does your breathing get better when you sit up? Breathing that gets better when you sit up is, better when you sit up is congestive failure, pulmonary edema. Congestive failure, pulmonary edema. What are you going to ask? You've got to ask them, do you have a history of asthma or emphysema? If you have a person who comes to the emergency room with shortness of breath, and you present that to your attending, and the attending says to you, this person got asthma? And you go, no. The attending looks at you close and goes, did you ask? Awkward moment. Should I lie? What you immediately do, if you forgot to ask something, you immediately say, I didn't ask. I'm going to find out right now. I'll get right back to you. I'll find out right now and I'll get right back to you. I'll find out right now and I didn't get back and I'll get right back to you. What do you do if you forgot something? You say, I'll find out right now and get right back to you. I'll find out right now and I'll get right back to you. Because he's going to think, what do you mean? It's one of the most common reasons to be short of breath. You had to ask that. Now you can see that it wouldn't be fair, right? You're a brand new third year medical student and you haven't learned to put the pieces together. Because you can study it from a book forever. You can learn it for step one forever. But there's a different thing to synthesize it when there's a sick human being in front of you. And all of a sudden, we all get like Alzheimer's disease or Creutzfeldt-Jakob. Like, yeah, I should have asked it. But you'll see that in the heat of the moment, we can't help but forget. Say, I'll ask right now and get right back to you. Have you had clots in your legs? Because when the person says, I have sudden onset of shortness of breath and the lungs are clear, your attending's going to say, well, does this person have a history of DVT? And you're going to go, don't say I forgot to ask. Say, I'll find out right now and get back to you. Because ultimately, that's what it means. Have you been hit in the chest? Such as this, people have chest wall trauma. They can have pneumothorax, tamponade, pneumothorax, tamponade, pneumothorax, tamponade. Sleepy during the day is because this is obstructive sleep apnea. This is obstructive sleep apnea. Maybe because somebody's like this. Yeah, I got sort of breath, but you know, I got hypertension. Yeah, I'm sorry. What'd you say? Sleepy during the day. Obstructive sleep apnea. Shortness of breath is a must know. Is it sudden in onset? Clots are sudden onset. Pneumothorax is sudden onset. And asthma exacerbation is sudden onset. Pleuritic means it changes with respiration. The pleura rubbing against each other. That's anything that begins with P. Isn't that convenient? Pneumonia. Pulmonary embolus. Pneumonia. Pneumothorax. Pleuritis. Isn't it nice how it all conveniently begins with P? I like that. I arrange that. Does it improve with sitting up? That's shortness, that congestive heart failure. Clots in the legs, or is it PE? And the other thing is, if it doesn't change at respiration, that's coronary disease. Trauma to the chest, like all the people. What about all the people exposed to motor vehicle accidents, trying to eat a steering wheel through your chest? Cardiac tamponade. You've got to have these cold. These have to be off the top of your fingertips 24 hours a day. And then, when you get called at 3 o'clock in the morning, when you're a big person later on, you'll be able to answer this stuff in your sleep. Don't show up without memorizing this. See you soon.